at my next service call. We got a RayPak pool heater. That's, God scared me. It's got an error again. Bet you they had rabbits and deer here. If it wasn't for that fence. Alright. Let's see what we got. Customer's complaint is that there's an error.
Oh. High pressure lockout. Yeah, that sucks.
Alright, because of that high pressure lockout, before I do anything, I'm gonna hook up my refrigeration probes to the high side and low side. And we're gonna see what our readings are. So we have 216 on the low side, 220, 262 on the high. That's smells like a frozen coil or a restriction somewhere in the system, and we probably have a stuck TX.
So I'm going to try to record this. Maybe we've gotten lucky here. We have 370 and climbing on our high side. 373. Low side, 153. 376.
Look at how this coil looks. Oh my God. The coil is coated.
Hold on. Turn this off. Off. Jeez.
Jeez Louise, there's a freaking fur coat in this bad boy.
You gotta be kidding me. Oh my God.
Oh, it's one of those guys.
Oh yeah, we're gonna get you. Okay, you're dead.
There's another one too.
They're all over the place. There's another one. Those little lantern flies.
Look at this guy's coil. Come on, this can't be for real.
And that's a tick for sure. But look. I gotta find my brush, but for now. This is not normal. My God. Look at this.
All right. I popped off two of the side panels. I'm not gonna go crazy here. I just wanna see if my pressure issue gets resolved before I start investing a lot of time, which equals money here. Because we have other issues like a stuck TXV or
I don't want to waste too much time on that.
I wish that number would go down.
That much more dirt in the coil. Almost 400 PSI on our high side. Ugh.
All right, after brushing off the coil and letting everything settle down, our low side pressure 157, high side of 377. Pool temperature is 87 degrees. Outlet temperature is 91. My ambient discharge is 71 degrees. And my outdoor ambient is 83.
I think I'm just gonna rest on top of this heat pump for the rest of the day. Guys, this stresses the importance of maintenance on your equipment, whether it's your central air conditioning system or your heat pump for your pool. Don't neglect it. It's like driving your car indefinitely. You wouldn't do that unless you do periodic maintenance as scheduled. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, and you're talking about your HVAC contractor, maybe they're just resting on top of an AC unit, heat pump cooling off on a hot 9-degree day. But if not, give us a call, 516-348-6300. Catch you in the next one.
Would you like the condensed version or the long story?
The condensed version.
It had an error called high lockout.
Okay.
You have a heat pump, which is similar to an air conditioning system. High pressure means something went wrong and it shut itself down to protect itself.
Okay.
When I first got it, that's what it said on the display. So I reset it.
Okay.
And I hooked up gauges similar to an air conditioning system to see where these pressures were at. And they were high, but not too high.
Okay.
So I checked the coil on the outside, and I know we cleaned it a couple years ago, and it was dirty again.
Okay.
So I just brushed it down, nothing crazy, brushed that down, and let it run for 20 minutes, and the pressures are slightly high, but are where they should be according to the manufacturer, which I called. If it reoccurs, a couple things you could do is homework. You can reset it and see if the fan comes on top.
Okay.
Right now it works. Everything's working fine.
How do you reset it?
You just push the menu button and it'll revert back to
just cool. Hit menu, just
yeah.
Hold it down.
Just press it once.
Okay.
And if the fan doesn't come on and you hear like things going on inside, that's a problem, just let us know, turn it off. And if it goes away, after that you have there's another problem, and I want to give you the summary version of it. But there's a part inside that regulates the pressures.
Okay.
And that could be dying, even though it's working fine now. You know, I'm not here, I can't be here 24/7, but
okay.
that could be a failure.
Okay.
And if that is the case, you're going to want to probably consider replacing the heater. Only because, I'm saying we do it anyway, but only because of the amount of history you've had with this. I know we've been here like 3 or 4 times, replacing parts in it over and over and over again, so maybe you got a lemon, and I hate to say it, but...
Is it covered?
No, the warranty's 3 years.
So happy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions?